It is Sunday, October 30th, 2:44 p.m. I'm going to read Agape vel Liber C vel Azoth Sal Philosophorum, the Book of the Unveiling of the San Graal, wherein it is spoken of the wine of the Sabbath of the Adepts, being the secret instruction of the ninth degree. Weave the circle round him thrice, and close your eyes with holy dread, for he on honey dew hath fed, and drunk the milk of paradise. The sun is the wine, and the moon is the cup. Pour the sun into the moon, Hafiz. Preliminary Prayer. From thine hand, O Lord, cometh all good. From thee flow down all grace and blessing. The characters of nature with thy fingers hast thou traced, but none can read them unless he hath been taught in thy school. Therefore, even as servants look unto the hands of their masters, and handmaidens unto the hands of their mistresses, even so do our eyes look unto thee, for thou alone art our help. O Lord, our God, who should not extol thee? Who should not praise thee, O Lord of the universe? All is from thee, all is of thee. Into thee all must again re-enter. Thou art Lord alone, and there is none beside thee. Who shall then not praise thee, O Lord of the universe, unto whom there is none like? Whose dwelling is heaven without, whose temple is the heart within? O God, the vast and the minute, thou art in all things, and all things are in thee. O nature, thou self of nothing, for what else can I call thee? In myself I am nothing but self. In thee I am all that self of nothing. Live thou in me, and bring me to that self which is in thee. A charge of the OHO to Baphomet. Merlin, by the grace of God Triune, and by the favor and appointing of the Secret Master, called to the service of mankind, and exalted among you as the outer head of the order OHO unto Baphomet, Supreme and Holy King of Ireland, Iona, and all the Britons within the sanctuary of the Gnosis, most puissant and sovereign commander of the Holy Order of the Temple, Grand Master of the Knights of the Holy Ghost, greeting in peace in the most sacred and mysterious name of the true and living God Most High, and in the Word, and in the Holy Ghost. Hearken thou, O most illustrious and illuminated brother, unto my word, and give ear unto my counsel and reproof. Shut it up closely in thine heart, and set a seal upon thy lips. Whosoever is worthy to receive it, unto him shalt thou reveal it, and unto the faithful shalt thou make it known. Is there one among the very illustrious sir knights that are sovereign grand inspectors general who understandeth my word? Is there any within thy consistory that apprehendeth O.T.O.? Seek then and see, discover the inmost will of each knight, and bind him to thee by an oath. Further, thou shalt test him to the uttermost. Thou shalt pass him through the last of the ordeals. Then shalt thou initiate him privily into the ultimate mystery. Thou shalt make him a partaker of the final secret. For in this secret and in this alone resideth the Godhead. Yea, he that possesseth it is no more man, but God. Salutation of Baphomet. Baphomet, by the grace of God Triune, and by the favor and appointing of the OHO and the Secret Master, Rex Summis Sanctissimus, 10th degree OTO of Ireland, Iona, and all the Britons that are in the sanctuary of the Gnosis, Lieutenant Commander of the Holy Order of the Temple, unto the very illustrious Sir Knight Sovereign Grand Inspectors General of the Ancient and Accepted Rite, and of the 95th degree of the Royal Rite of Memphis, perfectly illuminated of our sublime 9th degree, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, one God, eternal, indivisible, omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent. The favor of God and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the abiding of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore. Amen. Hear now the secret of secrets, the key of all magic, revealed unto me for your instruction and behoof by the loving kindness of the OHO. Lege, Judica, Tasse, of the nature of the Arcanum. I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Apocalypse. Come unto me, that I may declare unto ye the wonder ineffable. Know that our beginning is in God, and our end in God. Wherefore this is the great work, to attain unto the Godhead. Pitiful and of tender love hath he revealed unto the wise men of old time the way of this attainment. The Gnostics and Manichees preserved it in their most secret assemblies, as they had received it from the greatest of the Magi of Egypt, nor were the Ophites ignorant of this mystery, nor the men that did worship unto Mithras. And the secret is hidden in the fable of Samson. our Lord Jesus Christ established it through the mouth of the beloved disciple. This was the inmost secret of the Knights of the Temple, and the Brethren of the Rose Cross concealed it in their College of the Holy Ghost. From them and from their successors, the Hermetic Brothers of Light, have we received it directly, and here declare it openly to you. Now then, learn that this secret consists in the knowledge of a peculiar rite and high mass to be celebrated in the temple of the Holy Ghost. Are ye not kings and priests unto God, very illustrious sir knights and perfectly illuminated brethren? This is the true sacrament by which ye are partakers of the very body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, not in his death, but in his resurrection. By this ye are made children of light, fellows of the Holy Ghost, perfect, pure, companions of the Sangreal, illustrious knights of the sacrosanct order of Kadosh. By this have ye the Gnosis. By this are ye counted among the dwellers of the sanctuary. Blessed are they that do this commandment, that they might have sight of the tree of life, and may enter it through the gate into the city. For without are dogs and sorcerers and whoremongers and murderers and idolaters, and whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. So saith he that is the root and offspring of David, and the bright and morning star. And the Spirit and the Bride say, Come, and let him that is athirst come, and whomsoever will let him take the water of life freely. Now then here followeth a reproof. A reproof. Sir knights, brethren, and comrades, recall the vows of your obedience. How is it then that you are ever dallying with dame or jousting with squire? By the eight pillars that support this holy house, it is not well, sir knights. Now ye know sooth fast that our law is joy, that by virtue we deny not manhood, but in this ye err, that in your sport ye look not beyond to the mighty work of the vow. Is not this the essence of the proof, the substance of the ordeal? Whether therefore ye foin or joust, as St. Paul the good knight saith in his epistle, do all the glory of God. Even at the moment when the device of the demon grippeth at his strongest, play the man, aspire fervently toward the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, considering his crucifixion between two thieves, is not the lance that pierced him in my charge? And giving up the ghost to the Father either by action or by passion. Say we not non nobis domine non nobis? And again, excendat in nobis dominus ignem sui amoris et flammum aeternae caritatis? That is to say, thy purity not mine, and this is the descending and indwelling of the Holy Ghost. Nay, verily, deus est homo, deus est in homine, homo est deus, quem creavit Elohim. Male and female are those, therefore is these. Therefore in this ye do well, and in this ill, for that ye arrest aspiration, that ye suffocate and expire even at the moment when else how the threshold should be trodden and the shrine unveiled. Behold, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and I prophesy. Unless ye repent, then will the Lord root out your order from its place. I, the Lord, will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. Ye shall be the scorn of evil men, and your reproach shall be in the mouths of women. In the great name of Baphomet do I exhort you, that ye turn swiftly to the Lord, if so be that the mercy of the lion and the serpent may be upon you in the name of Mithras, Abraxas, Iao, Sabao. Go then, sir knights, rejoice in dame and squire, but let not your understanding be darkened, or your wisdom be balked of its effect. In beauty behold the crown ineffable, and beyond the crown that wonder which awaiteth him that is faithful to his oath, and is chaste in the ambush of life, as in the set field of his probation. And the blessing of God be upon you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Tractate of the Great Hidden Thing in the Palace of the King. Be it now understood further concerning the interchange of opposites, that albeit man is active and woman passive, yet man is peace and woman power, and this is called the Hermetic Paradox, and he that hath ears to hear, let him hear. There is, therefore, one magic act that leadeth into life, another that abutteth upon death, and the first ultimateth and the second returneth unto itself. Yet therefore is the last perfect, a true rite of the highest, too exalted for the vulgar, even of our holy and illuminated brethren. And in its profanation it cometh forth from the demon, and is manifested in all uncleanness, even as it is written, Demon est deus in versus. Yet is it, albeit limited and unable to proceed from life to life, the highest of all means of grace. For as wine is to water, so is it unto the others in its exaltation of the soul of man, and whoso mastereth the same, even he is found worthy of rule. This was the secret of the strength of our grand master, Caius Julius Caesar, this of our brother Richard Wagner, that was grand organist in Bavaria, and of so many others, whose fame is eternal without our order as within, that they are the stars of heaven for multitude and glory. To this aspire ye above all things, for the true light abideth therein yet more intensely than in the other. For he that reverseth the whirlings of matter is greater than he that worketh in them. Woe therefore, woe exceeding, unto him if failing in strength he be swept away into the abyss. Awake, my lords, be vigilant, be stern, be austere, be on your guard, for they that seek to devour you are about the gate. But of all this it is not written here. This is the book of the pathway that leadeth unto life. Of the Alchemists. Our illuminated brethren the alchemists, being wise with the wisdom of God, and cunning with the cunning of men, did apply themselves more especially to physical magic, to the finding of the medicine of metals, and the philosopher's stone, the tinctures white and red, and the elixir of life. For, said they, with wealth cometh leisure, and with health energy, and with long life an extension of time. All these will we devote to the performance of the great work. These secrets they indeed possessed, and the tradition handed down through centuries hath not been lost. O highly favored of God, O chosen from among men, O thou on whom the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ hath fallen, it is to thee that we reveal the secret ineffable, and not to be divined. To thee do we entrust the Arcanum Arcanorum, the hidden treasure of the wise. Without it all is cold, inertia, death. Within it fire, energy, genius, creation. This is the key to every door in the kingdom of heaven. This is the scepter of the realms that are. The possession and right use of this secret giveth 100 powers. Yea, verily, 50 is the numeration of the reward thereof. For this mystery is of Jove himself, whose letter is PK, and these are the initials of our Athanor and our Cucurbite, their names in the language of the Greeks. Yet of all these powers I name but 7, the glories of Eulis, the stars upon the foreheads of the brothers of Hermetic Light. Luna. And of these the first is the building up of one that is not born, verily a child of wonder shall he be. Venus. And the second is the harmony and the mastery of one coeval and cooperative with thee from eternity, twin with thee and thy mate. Mars. By the third cometh youth and beauty and energy, be thou never so old. Saturn. By the fourth is life prolonged at will. Mercury. The fifth is the attainment of the supreme, the magic of light. Jupiter. The sixth guardeth and abideth thee in the world wherein thou workest. To high rank and honor shall it lead thee, and from thy hands shall pour forth rivers of blessing. Yea, verily, and amen. Soul. And by the seventh thou hast all light, and knowest the cause of all, understanding alike the earthly and the spiritual soul of man. Is not this a possession worthier than all the dross of earth? Is not this a pearl richer than all the treasures of the seas? Is not this a goal for whose attainment thou shouldst fling away every garment, a prize to gain which no training is too tedious, no toil too arduous, no sacrifice too great? Thou hast aspired and thou hast attained. It is this no less, that this hour I crown thee withal here in the sanctuary of the Gnosis, illustrious, illuminated, and now thrice holy brother. Of Nature. First learn this concerning nature. The basis of mineral life is hyal and is dark. The base of vegetable life is chlorophyll and is green. The basis of animal life is blood and is red. The basis of divine life is light, whose feeblest reflections are beyond violet. Thus, in our order none may wear any ornament of violet save the OHO and his immediate representatives the MWSGMG and MPSGC of GL and SGC, the most holy supreme kings 10th degree that rule in every land. Of the name of God. I beseech you to understand, very illustrious sir knights and perfectly illuminated brethren, that this secret dependeth, first and last, upon the One Most High. He is not one whom our minds may apprehend, and although our hearts dissolve in love, we may not attain to him, for he abideth as the sun of our soul, that reflecteth him indeed, but absorbeth him not. Now he is the Father that createth, the Word that transmitteth, and the Spirit that receiveth, And also the Spirit proceeding from the Father is the essence that writeth the Father to the Son. And this mystery is concealed in many sacred names, that have been revealed to you, very illustrious Sir Knights and perfectly illuminated brethren of our ancient order. Learn therefore now this, the third motto of our supreme council, which it signifieth mystically, Deus est homo, that is, God is man, the which saith that, as above, so below, as without, so within. There is no part of man that is not God, and there is no part of God that hath not its counterpart in man. Now learn also this, that God is never to be known by thee, for all thou knowest is but thy creation as truly as thou art his. Thou knowest him as thou art he. Now there are three that bear witness in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Spirit. And these three are one, and there are three that bear witness on earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, and these three are one. In that Trinity, IAO, I is the Father, A the Spirit, O the Word. And in this, Aleph the Spirit, Mem the water, Shin the blood. And in all these are 358, Moshiach the Messiah, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in his death who gave up the Spirit, the water, and the blood, as St. John beareth witness in his Evangel. Hence is Jesus Christ Alpha and Omega, the symbol of the union of God and man. Here then is a second Trinity, God, God-man, and man. And to this God-man our ancient brethren have given many names. And though this name of Jesus Christ hath been universally blasphemed by Christians, yet this name hath been acknowledged by the true brothers of the Rosy Cross, and this which is written of him in the Evangels and in the Epistles in the Apocalypse is true, if it be interpreted in light by the adepts of the stone. For in God-man is our salvation. In him we are both God and man. Yet the testament thereof, being betrayed and given to the multitude, hath been profaned. As it is written, Cast not your pearls before swine, lest they turn again and rend you. Therefore, for their ill guarding of the secrets, have the adepts been persecuted these 2,000 years. See thou to it, very illustrious Sir Knights, that through no fault of thine the truth be lost. Trust not a stranger, fail not of an heir. Of the secret of Freemasonry. Now of him is our Lord the Son, Father, Creator, Preserver, and Destroyer, One, Exalted, Perfect, Giver of Life and Death, Vicegerent and Vice-Regent of Heaven, and upon earth and his representative, the Sacred Eidolon, within the Ark of the Covenant, of whom even in this place we speak not but in hidden terms, for that he is sacred in secret, beyond all that are or may be, the rod wherein Prometheus brought down fire from heaven. And either image and son of the All-Father undergoeth death and resurrection, and the feasts of one and the other have been celebrated throughout all recorded time by the initiates of all faiths. And the vulgar, ignorant of this, have mingled the two worships, appointing the times of one and the seasons of the other, the observances of the second and the ordinances of the first in the same ritual. Wherefore have minds been darkened and understandings confounded. Thus, at Easter is the crucifixion or copulation, and 9 months later is the birth of the child, which liveth 33 years, being a generation of mankind, and is crucified. Yet is this coming led with the descent of the sun below the equator, and his resurrection, and again with the daily agony of the sun. Now then, our brethren, having the true keys of all religion, namely that all cults typify either the mysteries of Lingam and Yoni, or of Sol, Luna, and Terra, can for themselves interpret all rites, create new faiths and new feasts, ruling the world in justice and righteousness under the supreme and most holy King, 10th degree, that is to them Father and God. For this is the arcanum of the Erephants of old, that in this cult of the sun in heaven and of the phallus on earth, all men can unite, for that these mysteries are reasonable and true, and no man can deny them. This is that which is written, Peace on earth, goodwill toward men. And this is the true and final secret of Freemasonry. This Son, is it not the great architect of the universe, the father of the system, the eidolon of the macrocosm? And this phallus, is it not the great architect of this other universe of man, the father of the race, the eidolon of the microcosm? Is not this that truth which is established in the mouth of two witnesses? Wherefore, be ye vigilant, preserving that kingdom of God which is within you from defilement. Chaste unto your Lord that is light, life, love, and liberty indeed. Also, remember well that in all this instruction no word is wasted, and that by deep and continuous study of the text may ye enlighten your souls. Now then at last are ye indeed initiates of Freemasonry. Now at last are ye worthy to rule and govern the right and the law of righteousness and truth, giving light, life, liberty, and love to all men of full age, free and of good report, that solicit admission to the lodge of the Most Holy Trinity. The Most Holy Trinity, one and indivisible, is hidden by our Arian brethren in the Tridram Om, by our Egyptian brethren in the Tridram Amen, by our Gnostic brethren in the Tridram IAO, by our Hebrew brethren in the Tridram IHV and Amen, by our Chinese brethren in the Tridram Tao and its symbol, by our brethren of the Royal Arch in the tripartite word of their degree, by our Rosicrucian brethren in the Tridram INR and its symbols, by our Masonic brethren in the tripartite word of their degree of master, by our Christian brethren in the Tridram IHS, by ourselves in many ways secretly and openly in the Tridram OTO. Many other hieroglyphs of him are known to you, but all of these are one, and though he is all, and in all, and above all, yet there is one aspect of him on which all insist, namely, that by which he is one with our own nature, in flesh as in spirit. A second tractate on this Trinity. Washed in pure wine and consecrated with the smoke of the cates of light, come ye now with holy awe unto the shrine. Come ye trembling and joyous, while the veil of the most holy mystery is rent by the sword of your most high grand master. Behold, the Trinity, most holy one and indivisible, IAO. One is the most holy Trinity, and three are its persons or masks. One is its spirit, one its individuality, its permutation one. Ererita. It is the seed that persisteth in all mutation, being itself, immune and omniprehensive, IAO, Sabao. Now the Father is one, erect, single, eternal. And the Son is one in the likeness of the Father, yet in this double nature, being God-man, and herein is a mystery, for being the Word, he is the Spirit, going forth from the Father and creating the worlds. And the Spirit is one, not begotten, but preceding, the seed of which Father and the Son are in very truth but vehicles and guardians. And the nature of the Spirit is liberty, and as the wind, he goeth as it listeth him to impregnate the worlds. And as the Son is double, so is the Spirit double, for he is both male and female. For the dove is the bird of Venus, yet our ancient brother Marcus Valerius Martialis, that was Grand Order of the Roman Empire in the days of old, hath hidden the sacred phallus in this image. He is the mother, he is the womb. He is the sperm that fertilizes the ovum. Nay, but he is that fertilized and self-living thing, which is neither sperm nor ovum, but their marriage. The perfect tincture, the medicine of metals, the philosophical stone, the universal medicine and the elixir of life. He is that dove that, returning to the Ark of Noah, bore a branch of olive. He is the eagle of Jupiter, he is the swan of Brahma. From this duplicity of speech have sprung infinite confusion in the vulgar mind, for they understand not that man is the guardian of the life of God, woman but a temporary expedient, a shrine indeed for the God, but not the God. Thus do they blaspheme who worship the false trinity of Father, Mother, Son. Blind mouths that gape poison, let them perish in the day of be with us. Moreover, the Holy Spirit is the unity in the Trinity, for the Father and the Son are indeed guardians of the quintessence, heirs to the quintessence, and the substance of the quintessence, but they are not the quintessence itself. And this is of the Godhead. But in earth it is the Son that combineth Father and Spirit, as it were man and woman, God and man. Nor is this mystery to be understanded of him who is not practiced and perfect in this means of grace that is herein declared unto ye, O very dear and very illustrious and very illuminated brethren, of mediation. Now since he is all, and all things are referred to him, much confusion hath arisen, the many overwhelming the one. And herein is the reason whereof, and every woman is not a complete image of God in due proportion. Consider these words attentively and understand what they say not. Our brethren in China, to confirm a bargain, break the stick on which it is written, each party keeping half, so that only the fitting together of the two halves can the covenant be complete, so also is the kingdom of heaven. So also is this instruction, unless the other half be in thy mind, thou wilt not understand. This then is the covenant of the Creator, dividing that he may unite. In our Lord Jesus Christ is the great work accomplished. Here followeth Liber 333, chapter 36, the star sapphire. Let the adept be armed with his magic rood, and provided with his mystic rose. In the center let him give the LVX signs, or if he know them, if he will and dare do them, and can keep silent about them, the signs of Nox, being the signs of Puer, Vir, Puella, Mulier. Omit the sign IR. Then let him advance to the east and make the holy hexagram, saying Pater et Mater Unus Deus Errorita. Let him go round to the south, make the holy hexagram, and say Mater et Filius Unus Deus Errorita. Let him go round to the west and make the holy hexagram, and say Filius et Filia Unus Deus Errorita. Let him go round to the north, make the holy hexagram, and say Filia et Pater Unus Deus Errorita. Let him then return to the center, and so to the center of all, making the rosy cross as he may know how, saying Errorita, Errorita, Errorita. In this the signs shall be those of Set triumphant and of Baphomet. Also shall Set appear in the circle. Let him drink of the sacrament, and let him communicate the same. Then let him say, Omnia in duos, duo in unum, unus in nihil. Hoc nec quator, nec omnia, nec duo, nec unus, nec nihil sunt. Gloria patri et matri, et filio et filiae, et spiritui sancto, et terno et spiritui sancto, in terno ut erit est, erit in saeculo saeculorum, sex in uno pronomen, septum in uno errorita. Let him then repeat the signs of Lux, but not the signs of Nox, for it is not he that shall arise in the sign of Isis rejoicing. Of the great symbol of God. Beware, very dear brother, lest thou fall into confusion in the consideration of the unity, for the first principle appeareth under opposite forms. He is thy father and thy mother, even as thy conception of him changeth. Now male is opposite to female, but in him is no opposition. Study then the complete symbol, and howsoever thou mayest change, he changeth not. Go thou from the abyss to the abyss. Thou shalt find him alway not, and alway many, and alway one, and alway all. Now the complete symbol, as hath been said, is triune, yet often have the wise and holy men of old glyphed it as two in one, leaving the third invisible. Such symbols are the point within the circle, the lingam yoni, the rose and the cross, the divided circle of the Chinese, the cross within the circle, of the diamond, the spire and nave of a church, the triple and elevenfold cross and the invisible diamond, which a member of our Supreme Council prefixeth to a signature and many another. And of these symbols every one showeth forth the work, the uniting and rapture of the divided. Conceive of these as, 1. God and man in man-god, 2. Subject and object in samadhi, and 3. Male and female in mankind, or, as thou wilt, it is all one. Of the one substance. God, in spirit and truth, is one, and one also is God in matter and illusion. O brethren, O illuminated and illustrious Sir Knights, hold this firmly as the sword-hilt in the hour of peril. One is the essence of God, and one is the essence of man. Yet since God is only one because he is three in one, so man is only one when he is two in one. As God's essence abideth in himself, so also with the essence of man. Yet man being not himself holy, but part of himself, this essence is not holy in him. It is found in perfection only without himself, and he can only attain it by virtue of the sacrament of the Eucharist. Of the sacrifice of the Eucharist. Read first in the Authorized Version, John chapter 4, verses 13 through 16 and 31 through 32, chapter 6, verses 27 and 48 through 58, chapter 8, verse 38, and St. Paul, 1 Corinthians, chapter 10, verses 1 through 4, 16 through 17, and 23 through 30, and chapter 12, verse 3. The sacrament is administered under two kinds, bread and wine. Bread is solid, white, the fruit of the earth, the substance of man, the body of Christ, the white tincture. Wine is liquid, red, the fruit of the vine, the cordial of man, the blood of Christ, the red tincture. This divided sacrament is mortal, the great work is not accomplished therein. The life resideth not in flesh or in blood, and though it be the body and blood of God, it is not God, for God slain is not God re-arisen. Therefore, very illustrious sir knights and my perfectly illuminated brethren, I charge ye earnestly to understand that this sacrament of death availeth little. Ye must partake of the life of our Lord Jesus Christ in his resurrection, and the substance of the sacrament will be the elixir of life itself. It will be one and not two, neither male nor female, neither solid nor liquid. It will contain all possibilities, and without it no possibility could be. It is the fire of Prometheus and the well-tended lamp of Vesta. It is the neph of the priests of Memphis, the disk of the sun in the arms of Khephra, and the serpent entwined about the egg. Ask of our brethren the alchemists and of the adepts of the Rosy Cross. The first answer, it is nothing but the lion with his coagulated blood, and the gluten of the white eagle. It is the ocean wherein both sun and moon have bathed. The others, it is the dew upon the rose that hath concealed the cross. Ask of the ancients, they reply that the oldest of the gods is Saturn. Beware lest thou also be deceived. Blessed be he that hath discovered unto us the Arcanum Arcanorum. This is the dissolved stone. This is the elixir of life. This is the universal medicine. This is the tincture. This is the potable gold. Take an Athanor and Cucurbite, and prepare a flask for this wine of the Holy Ghost. Thou needest also a flame for the distillation. In the Athanor is the lion, in the Cucurbite thine eagle. Use first a gentle heat, increasing at last to full flame until the lion passeth over. Pour immediately thy distillation into the flask prepared for it. Of the elixir. All being now clear to you, very illustrious sir knights and my illuminated brethren, hasten not to the sacrament, for this festival is holy. This wedding is of the soul with our Lord Jesus Christ, and thou must be adorned, as it is written, the king's daughter is all glorious within. Her raiment is of wrought gold. First therefore observe, as thou hast sworn the rule of chastity, for thou must be virgin unto thy Lord. Second, do thou fast, worshipping God Triune for 7 hours before the feast. Third, be thou clothed in one vestment many colored, which was bestowed upon thee at thine initiation. Now then, entering the privy chapel, do thou bestow at least 1 hour in adoration at the altar, exalting thyself in love toward God, and extolling him in strophe and antistrophe. Then do thou perform the sacrifice of the Mass. The elixir being then prepared solemnly and in silence, do thou consume it utterly. And in all this thou shalt direct thy whole will unwavering to the particular purpose of the operation. Otherwise have faith in God, that he may apportion its virtue to thy needs. This is the noblest way, and yet most dangerous, for thereby thou risketh profanation, eating and drinking damnation to thyself. Remember also this, that to obtain the utmost from this work, thou needest experience and well-guided practice. Even as thou sowest seeds in ignorance of seasons and of climates and of soils, some only may germinate. When the wise husbandman will reap all in the perfect harvest, so do thou reflect that the Eucharist is of such nature that some result will follow. For the grace of God cannot wholly be balked and fail of its effect, yet it will be better daily as thou followest out this path. And if thou wert with intelligence and energy, thou shouldst attain the highest perfection, and accomplish the great work, before the earth hath twice fulfilled her orbit. So mote it be. Of rhythmic incantation. This elixir is the germ of life. Therefore, although the most powerful, the most radiant thing that existeth in the whole universe, being as it were the very eidolon of our Father the Son, it is also the most delicate and sensitive of all things. During the preparation, as at the consumption, do thou guard it with flaming swords, set every way to keep its gate, and do thou cherish it, and involve therein the light of the Most High, and the might of the forces of thine operation. And this mayest thou do in this wise. First, let thine whole work be within the magic circle. Next, let the powers of incantation, as may be appropriate, utter themselves forth by spells and invocations. Lastly, at the beginning of the work proper, and thence throughout, let there be one incantation rhythmic with the progress of the work. For a work venereal, to Venus orta Mari, Venius to Filia Patris, exaudi penis carmina blonda praetor, nascit culpa nates nobis futuis viriles, sed caliat cunis semper amore meo. So for all, in such words as thy poetic genius may overshadow thee withal. Of the law. Love is the law, love under will. Is not agape of one numeration with the lemma? The word of sin is restriction. Do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law. It is also written, take your will and fill of love as ye will, when, where, and with whom ye will, but always unto me. But ecstasy be thine and joy of earth, ever to me, to me. I charge you, very august, excellent, puissant, and perfect sovereign princes of Rose Craw, Sir Knights Companions of the Holy Grail, even by your sublime chastity and the vow of stainless manhood, that ye understand these words. Behold, I have declared the law, unto you I have revealed it, I have manifested the tokens to you, with you I have exchanged the words. Conquerors of sin and sorrow, partakers of the cup of blessing, initiates of the supreme rite, warders of the ineffable sanctuary, free men of the city of truth, saints of the everlasting tabernacle, I have discovered unto you the Eucharist of resurrection. I have shown you the way. I have spoken unto you the truth. I have endowed you with the life. Sons of heaven and daughters of earth, children of God and inheritors of immortality, the feast is ready in the mansions of my Father. Brothers of light, life, love, and liberty, illustrious Sir Knights of the Order of Kadosh, strike with the pommels of your swords upon the gate of this sanctuary, the inmost, the unprofaned, the shrine which we have guarded for you through all catastrophes of empire from the days of Enoch until now. Knock, and it shall be opened up to you, and ye shall enter in and taste that manna that cometh down from heaven. Farewell. And now, very illustrious Sir Knights and highly illuminated brethren, hail and farewell. I salute you secretly as is right. I exchange the token. I whisper the word, even as I received it, and in no other manner. I kiss thrice the hilt of the sword. I invoke upon you the blessing of God Triune. I invoke upon you the blessing of God Triune, in his most sacred and mysterious name of omnipotence, omniscience, and omnipresence. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, take my leave of you. The favor of the true and living God Most High be upon you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. The abiding of the Holy Ghost be within you. Now and forevermore, so mote it be. Amen. De Templo. 1. Oriente, Cubiculum. 2. Occidente, Tabula de Invocandi. 3. Septentrione, Sacerdos. 4. Meridione, Ignis cum Thribulo Ctl. 5. Centro, Lapis Quiratis cum Imagine, De Maxima Ingentis Terribilis Omnipotentis Sanctissimi et cum Ferro Tintinabulo, Oleo Virgo, Stet Imago Juxta Librum Thelema. De Ceremonio Principii. Fiat ut in Liber 671 dissitur, sed antea Virgo lavabitur cum verbis. Aspergo me ctl et habilimenta ponat cum verbis. Per sanctum mysterium ctl. Ita pyramis fiat, tune Virgo lavabit sacerdotum et vestimenta ponatut supra ordinatur. Haec decat Virgo orationes de operationes. De ceremonio thribuli. Manibus excenda et idnum et sacerdotum Virgo descends. Excenda in nobis dominus idnum sui amoris et flammum aeternae caritatis. De ceremonio dedicationis. Invocet Virgo imaginum de mitos his verbis tu qui es praetor omnia ctl. Nec relinque alternam imaginum. De sacrifico summo. Deinde silentium frangat sacerdos sum verbis versiculi sancti di particulariter invocandi, iniat sanctum sanctorum, caveat caveat caveat, duo qui fiunt unus sine intermissione verbe versiculi sancti alta voce content, de benedictione benedicti. Misa rore dicat mulie hac verba, qui patris et filii, sscit. De ceremonio finis. Fiat ut in Liber 671, dissitur, Amen.